Hello everyone, welcome to Getting Started video series for Tableau Test Studio. In this video, I'm going to talk about how we can use Headless Browser to perform our tests. If we use Headless Browser, then Test Studio doesn't even open a browser in order to perform tests, which saves a lot of memory and time for our machine. We'll also check out what our test list, how we can create a group of tests and run them together. We can also schedule these test lists so that we can run a group of tests whenever we'd like to run. We'll also check out how we can run this test list using Headless Browser so that your machine doesn't even have to open a browser to perform a group of tests. Whenever we need to run a test, we would either right-click on a test and click on Run Test, or you can click on this Execute button in Tests tab, which will open a pop-up where we can select the browser which we want to use for running this test. I'm going to select Chrome browser, and whenever I click on Run, then it opens an instance of a browser, it loads an extension, and it'll show us the steps that we have recorded, and it'll perform all the steps, and it'll make sure that these steps are passing, and so is our test. But if we select Headless Browser, then it does not open an instance of a browser. Let's do that. For that, I'm going to clear these results, and then I'm gonna right click on our test and click on Run Test. Then we have this Headless Browser option here. I'm going to select this and then click on Run. Then Test Studio does not even need to open an instance of your browser to perform all our steps. You can see all the steps running here in the Visual Debugger. It performs all the steps and it will make sure that our tests are passing. That way you can save some memory and time for your machine and run your tests in the background. We can create a group of tests and run them together by using test list. Let's create a test list for some of the tests that we have. For that, I'm going to go to test list tab, and here I'm going to click on create list. This will open a pop-up where we can select the test that we would like to put it in a group. I'm going to put cascading drop-down list, create new author, create new publisher, is grid loaded, navigate to pages, profile picture exists test in a group. Now here we have a test which is creating a new author, and in this test I'm checking if author's grid has 19 items in it or not. If we run this test after this test, then it's going to fail our test list. But we can use these arrows to reorder our tests in test list. I'm going to push this test second in order so that our test list does not fail. I'm going to click on this move up arrow and put it second in the list so that this will just work fine. Let's go ahead and name our test list. I'm going to name it as bookstores daily test, and then I'm going to click on OK. Now we have a test list which has 6 tests in it. Now you can either run this test by clicking on this Run List button, or you can right click on it and select Run List. This will open a test runner which will open an instance of a browser for each and every test, and it will perform all the steps and make sure that our test is passing or not. I'll speed through this process so that I can show you how the results look like. Now you can see that it performed all the tests, and you can select the result by clicking on this bookstore's daily test in this calendar. And you can see the result is 6 tests passed out of total 6 executed on this machine. You can also take a look at the logs which got logged whenever we ran the test by clicking on this button. It'll open the logs and show you what exactly happened in particular test. So if particular test is failing, then you can check the logs and fix your tests. You can also schedule your test list. You can go to test list tab here again and select your test list and click on schedule list, which will open a pop-up where you can select the time and date when you want to run a particular test list. You can also make them recurring and run them weekly, daily, monthly, yearly, depending on whenever you'd like to run them. If I click on next, it'll ask you the machine that you would like to select for running this test list. You don't need Test Studio to be open in order to run these test lists. You can even run these test lists by using headless browser, so that Test Studio doesn't have to open Chrome instance for each and every test which is running in this test list. For that, I'm going to select the test list and click on Edit Settings and go to Web tab, because we are running web tests. And here I'm going to select the browser as Chrome headless and then click on OK. Once I do that, then I'm gonna right click on my test list and run this test. And this time you'll see that it's not opening a Chrome instance. It's not loading that extension. It's not showing us what all steps that it's performing. It's showing the steps in this test runner console so that it could save some time for your machine for executing this test. This is even better when you have scheduled your test, so that your machine is not going through opening and closing your browsers. That's all about test lists and running them using headless browser. If you have any questions, you can post this in the comment section below, or you can reach out to me on my Twitter handle, or you can send me an email at qsdrive@gmail.com. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.